started off with my normal foundation, creating a blank canvas for the rest of the makeup to go on. Then I put a piece of sticky tape over where I think the straight line should start and where the ombre effect will go down and start from. If you feel confident that you can do your own straight line across your face without having to rip out half of your eyebrows while you take the sticky tape off, you can do that, but I wasn't feeling confident, so I just went over the line, over the stick tape to create myself a really straight line. Then I went over the red line thicker, making sure I don't stuff up that straight line I got. I chose really warm colours because it just went with my hair, and I thought I kind of looked, my hair was golden and sun-like, so it's kind of like a sun tribal princessy thing that I'm going for. I kept on going down with more colours, blending it out, so it went from red, fluoro orange to yellow. You can do a completely different colour palette. You can go from blues to greens, you can do pinks to... You can do so many colours, you don't have to just choose three as well. I went past my nose because I thought any further would look a bit awkward. Then I went over my lips with my everyday concealer that I use to make my face look that extra bit blank, so when the details are put on, they'll pop out a bit more. All of the different colours I used in this tutorial are water-based paints. The details, if you're going for a tribal look, are normally very pointy and sharp and square and that. So if you're going to create your own design for this, just stick with those types of shapes. I just go over my chin with a triangle, and then my lip was a rectangle, and then I connected them together. Then I go along both of my cheekbones with two lines. You can do them however you want. You can change the way this design looks, but I did two big lines along there and put dots on each end of them and just went over them to thicken them up a little bit. Then I go along each eyebrow with the same white paint and the end of my paintbrush and do the dots along my eyebrows. These look really good and they make everything else stand out a bit more. And then do the three big dots going down my forehead that are going from bigger to smaller. Again, you can change this to however you want. I searched up on the internet different tribal looks and from different movies and just different things to get inspiration and even Aztec kind of things. I add some mascara and then I do my eyeliner, just simple winged liner. It doesn't have to be perfectly perfect. As you can see, it just makes everything look so much more magical, mystical on that one side. And I go on the bottom of my waterline as well. Then I do it on the other eye. Then I start on the neck and doing the exact same ombre pattern that I did on my face, except kind of in the opposite way. So I started off with doing the orange as a base, but that was just because that was the largest thing that was going to take up most space. Then I added the orange and blended that out, and then went in with the red around it and blended that out because there wasn't very much of it. So I started with the orange because that was going to take up most of the space. Then I went in with the end of my paintbrush as well and dabbed dots all along my chest like that. And I just continued the triangle down onto my neck, just to give that chest just a bit more pattern because I thought it looked a bit blank. Then I add two triangles under my eyes because I thought under my eyes even a little extra, and then that was done. You can decide to do your hair however you want. I just shook my hair up quite a lot and add some dry shampoo and shake it up. I thought it looked really cute with a little ponytail like that. You can add a ribbon across your head and make it look more tribal. But that is the final look, and I really hope you enjoyed this quick tutorial. It was really fun to do. I hope you enjoy being a tribal princess. I know I did, and have a good day.